Hi, this is Mark Drinkwater from Dialogue Solutions, and this is another of our short video explainers about the main challenges organisations face when monitoring scientific literature for drug safety. This session is about effective deployment of resources. So, what's the problem? Anyone taking the time to watch this will know that scientific literature is a key resource for the identification of patient safety issues relating to drugs. The regulators typically expect MAHs to assess scientific literature for three things. The first is ICSRs, the second is periodic safety update reports, and the third is potential new safety signals. The challenge is that the qualifications, skill sets, training, and expertise required to identify each of these things is rather different. Spotting the four criteria for an ICSR is a lot more straightforward compared to understanding whether the safety relevant information in the article is relevant for an aggregate report or not, or harder still, if it's a potential safety signal. Compounding this challenge is the fact that the clock is ticking loudly with respect to identifying ICSRs in a way that it's not for aggregate reports or safety signals. Some companies try to address this by having their product safety specialists assess the literature for all three areas at the same time. The problem with this is that the product safety specialist skills are in high demand, dealing with the rising tide of work drug safety departments are increasingly having to deal with. And using the product safety specialist to perform ICSR assessments is a bit like getting the pilot of the plane to also drive the bus that takes the passengers from the jet to the airport terminal. What makes things even worse is that having to perform the more complex and time-consuming assessments for aggregate reports and safety signals at the same time as the ICSR slows down each assessment and puts the product safety specialist under intense time pressure to complete all their reviews and still leave enough time to get the ICSR's submission ready. Other companies create two work streams, where the references are sent to both literature reviewers for ICSR assessment and to product safety specialists for aggregate reports and safety signals. Although this takes most of the time pressure away from the product safety specialists and does not waste their time making assessments for ICSR, it does mean that every reference is looked at twice, effectively doubling the effort and cost. And it always creates a conundrum for the product safety specialist when they notice that the piece of literature contains an ICSR. Do they rely on the fact that their literature reviewer colleague spotted the ICSR, or do they use their precious time to check? So what's our solution? We have a proven approach that allows you to maximise the quality of review whilst minimising the effort required by deploying your resources to assess the references in a two-step workflow on our drug safety triage system. In the first step, literature reviewers assess every reference for ICSR and eliminate those that are irrelevant for safety. The drug safety triager directs only 20 to 30% of the references to the product safety specialists, allowing them to perform the aggregate report and safety signals after the more time-sensitive ICSR review. Overall, this reduces the amount of time the product safety specialists spend reviewing literature by up to 80%, and as each assessment for aggregate reports and safety signals costs at least 4 to 5 times that for ICSR, this delivers huge efficiencies and savings. If you want to learn more about this or how we're able to automate the review of literature for drug safety, contact us using the links on the screen